I'm going to explain how to examine your own joints and undertake a self-reported tender and swollen joint count. Karen Staniland has rheumatoid arthritis and will examine her own joints whilst I show her how to do it. I'll explain why examining your joints is important and then show you how to examine all the relevant joints. Karen and I will then discuss some frequently asked questions. You can pause the video whenever you wish, and you may want to replay it before having a go at examining your own joints. Or you can try examining your joints as we go along. All of the joint examinations are available as separate clips. We have developed a rheumatoid arthritis tender and swollen joint count model and table. This is available on the YouTube page where this video is hosted. You can download and print it to keep a note of the number of tender and swollen joints as you go along. You can tick off swollen and tender joints on the model or in the table and add them up at the end. These resources are available in the description box below the video. Assessing the number of tender and swollen joints is really important to help healthcare professionals calculate your disease activity. This tells them how active your rheumatoid arthritis is and guides treatment. Examining your own joints can be useful for your own understanding and to enable you to report to your healthcare professional. The most commonly used score in clinics is the DAS28 score. DAS stands for Disease Activity Score, whilst the 28 relates to the number of joints examined. It's made up of four components, including a tender joint count, a swollen joint count, a blood test measuring inflammation, so CRP or ESR, and the patient's assessment of their health over the last week. The 28 joints included in disease activity scores are the shoulders, the elbows, the wrists, the knuckles, middle joints on the fingers, and the knees. It's not that the other joints aren't important, especially from a patient point of view, just that they are not included in the measure. Joints might appear swollen for lots of reasons. In rheumatoid arthritis, healthcare professionals are looking for joint swelling caused by inflamed joint lining. This makes the joints feel quite soft and squidgy, like a grape. It's really important that only those joints which feel soft and squidgy are counted as swollen. This kind of swelling can last a long time or can come and go quite quickly. Joints can be swollen for other reasons apart from joint inflammation. Osteoarthritis is quite often present alongside rheumatoid arthritis. Osteoarthritic joints are very hard and bony and don't tend to change quickly. Although it will look swollen and can be tender to touch, this swelling is caused by bone, so will feel hard and not squidgy. These hard bony swellings do not count as a swollen joint. There are other structures around the joints which might make you think they are swollen, when they are not. Swelling outside the joint can include pockets of fluid called bursitis. Bursitis does not count as a swollen joint. Some people have rheumatoid nodules, which are knobbly swellings attached to the skin. Nodules do not count as swollen joints. The only type of swelling that counts in rheumatoid arthritis disease activity examinations is boggy swelling that feels like a grape due to inflammation in the joint. In this picture, the knuckle joints are swollen. Healthcare professionals use the word tender to describe joints that feel painful or sore. Joints may be tender and swollen, or just tender. You need to press on the joint either until it hurts or until your fingernails go white. If your joint is tender to touch, you don't need to press any harder, but you will still need to feel for swelling. When examining the joint, you need to feel for the joint line, which is where the ends of the two bones meet. This is where you'll be able to feel swelling, if there is any. I'll explain as we go through each joint where the joint line is and show you on a skeleton first. It's quite simple once you start having a go. So to examine your own joints, it's best to be comfortable And I usually start with the shoulder, working my way down through to the elbow and the wrist and the hands and then the knees, but you can do the examination in any order you like. Just to show you what a shoulder joint looks like, here's a skeleton. Here is the ball of the ball and socket joint. And this is where you'll be feeling for the joint line. To feel the shoulder joint, if you bring your hand up to the shoulder joint and feel with your thumb at the front of the shoulder and your fingers around the back of the shoulder, and if you just slightly move your shoulder and you'll feel it moving underneath your thumb, and that means you're right in the shoulder joint line, so you can feel if there's any swelling at all and if it's tender. How does that feel?
Okay, I can feel the space and it's not tender.
Great. With the elbow joint, you can see where the joint line is between these two bones. So to feel the elbow joint, if you bring your thumb and your fingers up to the elbow joint and with the elbow flexed or bent, and you can feel the round and knobbly bit of the elbow with your thumb.
Yes.
And finger.
I can feel the knobbly bit.
And if you just slightly move the elbow as well, then you'll know that you're right in the joint line.
Yes, I can feel it moving.
Great. Looking at the wrist joint, you can see the two bones and where they meet, the small bones of the wrist. Where the wrist bends is where the joint line is. To examine the wrist, if you have your hands resting on the pillow and with your hand come over to the top of the wrist with your fingers, and you can feel down past the two bony lumps of your wrist. And if you look at what I'm doing with my fingers, I'm bringing them across the wrist joint with the thumb underneath, but just with two fingers to examine the wrist joint. And then if you bend your wrist slightly, and you'll feel that you're right in the joint line. So you can feel if there's any swelling at all.
Yes, it feels quite squishy. And I think it's a bit swollen.
Okay, so does that feel like the grape that we...
Yes. Yes, it does, like a squishy grape.
Thank you. With the knuckles, the joint line is where the two bones meet and the joint bends. So to examine the knuckles, these are known as the MCPs for short, we're going to feel across from the thumb, across to the index finger, and then the other fingers. So if we start with the thumb joint,
yes,
and you're coming to just try and bend the thumb slightly and put your thumb and first finger over the joint, and you'll feel it moving underneath your fingers.
Yes.
And then you'll know you're in the joint line.
That's a little tender.
Okay. And if you come across then to the index finger knuckle, and again, those fingers are slightly bent.
Yes, that's a little bit swollen there.
And moving your hands across to feel the other joints. And you'll know you're in the joint line because you can feel a space.
Yes.
Okay. With the finger joint, you can see that the two joints bend, and that's where the joint line is. So let's examine the middle finger joints, which are also known as the PIP joints. The distal interphalangeal joints, the DIP joints, we don't examine in rheumatoid arthritis. So we could start with the thumb again, and using two fingers and a thumb, just gently feel around that joint, feeling for any swelling or tenderness, and moving across to the index finger. And again, with the finger slightly bent, or even moving underneath your fingers, you'll be able to feel that you're actually in the joint line and feeling for any swelling or tenderness.
I can feel that all my finger joints are tender and swollen at the moment, so I don't need to press very hard.
On the skeleton, you can see the knee joint is a hinge joint, and this is where the joint line is, where the two bones meet. Knee joint is a hinge joint, and so therefore when we're feeling the knee joint, what we're feeling for is the joint line where the two bones meet together. Now there's a lot of soft tissue around the knee joint, so you have to be aware of that when you're feeling the joint for any swelling or tenderness. So if you have your fingers behind the knee and your thumbs around the knee joint, you'll feel for these two dips either side of the kneecap.
Yes.
And then you can feel if there's any swelling in there at all. So if it feels boggy to the touch, and if there's any tenderness at all.
That feels fine.
And it's good to keep your knee relaxed as well, so the muscles at the top of the leg are relaxed, because it's so much easier then to examine the knee.
How do you know whether you're in the right place?
So this becomes much easier with time, and the more you examine your joints, the more you'll know you're in the right place. But it is particularly where you find the joints are moving underneath your fingers when you're examining your joints.
Why do I get swollen palms?
So swelling occurs in places other than the joints in rheumatoid arthritis. It can occur in the palms, on the backs of the hands, and it's important to make note of it, but it doesn't count when we're doing a disease activity score.
I often get swelling in one shoulder or one hand, but not the other. Is this normal?
So rheumatoid arthritis is always described as being symmetrical, but it's perfectly normal to have just one joint inflamed at a time.
Do nodules stay forever?
So nodules do stay for a long time, but sometimes they respond to treatment, so they may well go away.
Please explain why feet aren't included in the scoring. If you've got no tender and swollen joints anywhere else but you have in your feet, why are they not included?
So the joints that are used in the disease activity scores are reliable for assessing disease activity, but that doesn't mean to say the feet aren't important. They are affected in rheumatoid arthritis, and therefore it is really important that when you do see your healthcare professional, you do tell them that you have problems with your feet and that they can then have a look at them.